For the cheapest, fastest, most reliable buck coins in the market, check out my coin sponsors at AOEAH.com and use discount code MONEY for 3% off. Link in the description below. Welcome back, Money Team. This is Mad Money Shot. Sniff the Mad Cheese as always. We are at episode 5 of hoodie season, by the way. I'm not even sure. If anybody's actually following along with how many hoodies I've worn in a row, comment in the comment section how many videos I put out. Guarantee you that comment will get pinned. Otherwise, we're doing a run play scheme today out of what I think is probably the best run play book in the game, the Baltimore Ravens. The formation itself is the pistol strong slot. I have put out a ton of stuff out of just about every pistol formation in the Ravens. Personally, pistol formations are probably the second best formation in the game. After gun formations, pistol formations are definitely some of the best. And this is gonna be a very big run play scheme. So if you guys wanna see more out of this formation, as always, hit the like button and let me know in the comment section or check out my ebook link in the description below. The Ravens is one of my best every year. That's why I continuously go back to it. I love the Ravens playbook. I love the run plays, I love the trick plays. The running formations that are in this are just second to none. So as far as this goes, number one, you're gonna wanna make sure that you have an actual running back at your fullback spot because he's going to get the ball a lot. Then as far as my run plays go that I put in my audibles, there's not enough audibles for all the run plays in this, but my top four are the stretch alert dragon, the triple option, the jet touch pass, and the power option. These are probably the four most explosive on the in the formation, but there's still a lot more to go over. So this is gonna be a very lengthy video. I'm probably gonna have like 6 run plays, or I might just have a lot of extra plays on my Patreon on my Join Our Community tab. So guys, check that out if you wanna see the full breakdown. Or like I said, I know in my ebook, this is a very big formation in there as well, but there's a ton of really good plays, passing plays as well. Hit the like button to see a full scheme of this in the future date. The fifth best place for my fifth play would probably be the power O, but I wanna have a play running right up the gut, so I'll go ahead and I'll take the halfback dive. As always, this video is brought to you by my coin sponsors at AOEH.com. If you guys want to get your mutt team up, I know a lot of people are getting this game at Christmas and they're probably way behind. Check them out, link in the description below, and use discount code MONEY to get 3% off. It's always the cheapest coins on the market. So I know I picked some random plays here, but ultimately we're just gonna go play to play. The stretch alert dragon, I mean, this formation alone is a really tough formation based on the fact that you have two receivers on the left side there, no receiver on the right side there. Number one, it's going to give away a lot of defensive formations. And number two, it's going to create a lot of mismatches when it comes to run plays. I'm pretty sure that this formation was one of the formations that the guy who got to the end of the recent Madden tournament was running quite a bit. But I got to be honest with you, I really didn't watch too much of that. I really don't watch a lot of other people's stuff because I really don't want to feel, I don't want anybody to influence what I do. I try to be the influencer, not the other way around. But like I said, I did notice that one of these pistol formations was being run a lot by a guy who was the runner-up in the challenge championship. So take that for what it's worth. But ultimately, this particular series of plays here, if I see a cover three like I have here, I could run the stretch alert dragon, I could run the power option, I could run probably the power O if I had in my audibles. But I would say the power option is one of my favorite without a doubt. So like I said, that cover three cornerback is going to drop back. It's going to basically give me the opportunity to flip this ball out. Now, I thought the guy was going to tackle the quarterback there, so I would have kept it. As you can see, the quarterback got more than the running back did, but you can see that's a very good play. And in a play like this, looks like a man coverage, same thing, I can run it again. I wish I could flip this play like you can in some formations, but the power option is always some of the best. I mean, I just love power option plays. You can see right there, boom, we get that pitch out, and this guy is just basically in a full sprint to the end zone. So, like I said, the power option play is overpowered. I love the power option play. Like I said, these plays are broken. They're really not something that the computer can handle. Here we go. Just basically run. I'm going to run right into that guy, by the way. Every single time, I'm going to run into that read defender, which is something that I always want to try to break down when it comes to pistol play. So let's go to the replay one time, just to show you guys that EA has done a pretty good job. I don't want to say patching, but making defenses, you know, basically react to these things better. As you can see right here, I'm running straight for this guy. I'm not running around him. I'm running straight for him because you see how he's frozen? That's what I want. I'm running straight for him. I'm running straight for any read defender because I want to basically act like my own blocker and take him out of the play. Basically run towards him, pitch the ball out, boom, we have a, you know, I didn't actually block, but a lot of times they'll actually tackle the quarterback before you get the pitch out, which is even more helpful because then he's out of the play completely. But you can see the second I get that pitch out, he's 10 yards, 15 yards away from anybody. You know what I mean? Like, this is just, this is what you want. I mean, you have nothing but nothing with space out here. You get the pitch and yeah, you're at a loss at the moment, like you're 10 yards back. But once you get that pitch, it's more like 5 yards back. But once you get that pitch, you're just sprinting up the field and boom, there's nothing out here. I mean, I'm 10, 15, 20, 25 yards down the field before anybody's even close to me to make a tackle. That's one of the best ones without a doubt. But like I said, if I want to, the stretch alert dragon is an option. I really haven't run that yet. Just basically got to hand this off. You can see once again, the cover three cornerback drops back, gives me an opportunity to get to the outside. But to me, unless I plan on possibly throwing it, there's no real reason for me to run anything other than the power option. If I have the choice, I'm going power option. Although you can see right here, like on a pass play, this flat is going to be very useful. So like, this is something, this is definitely going to frustrate your opponents, keep your opponent honest. If it's a man coverage, like this looks like it might be the dragon. I mean, I don't think it's a man coverage, but if it is, once again, you can throw it to the slant. But like I said, this is just something, it's one of the better, you know, the stretch alert dragon is one of the better RPO plays in the game. But basically the stretch alert dragon, if it's a zone, you're going to go B. If it's a man coverage, you're going to go X. It's really that simple. And it's also a little bit easier. I mean,
good, that was a close one.
Almost threw an interception. But you can see, I mean, obviously, I guess I should amend that. You can throw it to the flat as long as it's not a hard flat. Any zone other than hard flats, the B route's going to get open. And then obviously, if it's a man coverage, the slant's going to get open. So like right there, if you make a poor read, like I made a poor read. I was waiting for a man coverage. I finally get a man coverage, I make a poor read, and I throw an interception. So as long as you make a good read, you'll have none of the success. But here we have that man coverage look. We have also the double blitzing safety. This is the perfect opportunity for the jet touch pass. This is pretty much the only scenario where I would use the jet touch pass. I do this in a lot of other schemes. Anytime you don't have a cornerback out here, this is the jet touch pass territory. So it doesn't matter the safeties are blitzing. That's not important. But the fact that we have no cornerback outside, this is where we're going to take advantage of this. We're going to get this guy here in a full sprint to the edge. And you can see, just as long as we take it to use up all of our blockers, there's nothing typical on the edge out here. And you get a very big play. Now, obviously, I'd be much happier if I had my fastest receiver there, but it's not a big deal. So here we go once again. We kind of don't have a cornerback out there. I mean, he's kind of tight to the line. So we could try that jet touch pass one more time. Like I said, all these plays are so good. It doesn't even matter which one you choose half the time. As you can see here, we just kind of got to go around a little bit. Like I said, we'll get to the edge every single time. If there's no cornerback out there, there's nothing to stop you. So here we go one more time. No cornerback. We're getting a real good stretch here. Once again, we could go power option. We could go stretch alert dragon. These are all good options, but we already showed those. So let's go ahead and let's move on to some other run plays. Like I said, I'm going to try to use that guy. A lot of times my speed is all I need. I mean, a lot of times if you have an outside linebacker or a defensive end out here, they're not going to be able to cut that off. As you can see, we're getting a real consistent streak. This is one of the reasons that this formation is so good, is because we have two receivers on the one side, it constantly creates a disadvantage like this on the weak side. So we'll do this one more time. Like I said, hopefully I can get a little bit more blocking from my running back because he's the one guy who's not really jumping in. But you can see, look at this. I mean, I'm just busting around the edge. Anytime I get a man coverage, that's going to be the results. So if your opponent starts overreacting to these plays to the outside, which they probably will, then you can switch over to the triple option and go the opposite direction. Now, I have a gap right there, but a lot of times I'm going to take this wide. You can see, like I said, if there is a gap right there, a lot of times that guard will get through. That's not typically my read. I typically want to take it wide. To me, there's much better triple option plays in the game. I personally like the one out of the pistol week, but this is a very good one. It's a very good counter play. You just got to remember to hold A and then basically just take it wide a lot of times in the opposite direction, which is really what's going to make this difficult. You have wide looping runs in one direction. Now I got a wide looping run in the opposite direction. Your opponent really doesn't have the ability to set anything up pre-snap to the point where they're going to be like, okay, I can, you know, this will be what I do against this. Or there's just no tell when it comes to this formation. Now here it looks like we have that cover three. I'm going to force the triple option, but I could easily go to the outside one more time. Like I said, I'm just going to hold it and try to go wide, wide, wide. This is a formation where I'm constantly running wide, although I haven't really touched up on the halfback dive yet, which is something that is, like I said, I left that there. I know that all these runs are wide to the left or the right. That's why I want my fifth play to be a dive, because if they start spreading, obviously the dive's going to be powerful. So here we go once again. No cornerback out here. Make that little shift. I'm glad we're gonna hit him with the hit him with this running back slash receiver. Like I said, there I didn't take a very good angle. And I don't have my fastest guy, but I'm easily getting 10 yards a pop every single time. I'm gonna end the video there though. All the additional plays, because I haven't recorded for 15 minutes. All the additional plays will be on my Patreon or my Join Now community tab. Or if you want a full breakdown of this in the future, hit the like button. Let me know in the comment section. I'll make sure to do that. Other than that, thanks for watching, man. Wish it out. Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my bids and more. Link in the description below. Thank you. Thank you.